There's a big difference between the food forest and the farm. The biggest difference probably would be that we work less in the food forest. We just gotta go in there once in a while and kind of maintain it. And in the farm, you really gotta be every day looking at everything and making sure everything's okay, it has water, and spraying it for insects, spraying it for with nutrients to feed the plants, and it's a lot more work that goes into the actual farm. We have all types of plants in the food forest. We have papayas, we have plantains, we have guavas, we have avocado trees. Fruit trees tend to give fruit more towards the summer and the spring, but there are fruit trees like bananas and plantains that we're getting fruit from now. It's pretty difficult to grow the cocoa tree in Florida, but there's things you can do to help that.
Cacao trees will grow anywhere around the equator, so within 10 degrees north or south of the equator. Yeah, they need very specific conditions. They need a lot of moisture. They don't like the direct sun. They need to grow in shade. When you open the pod and harvest the seeds, they're covered in a really sweet, pulpy skin. So that's a really delicious treat you can eat. Well, dark chocolate has just the pure ground cocoa beans. It has cocoa butter and sugar. Milk chocolate has milk, either evaporated or powdered milk, added to it. Absolutely, chocolate has benefits. Aside from being delicious, it has polyphenols, antioxidants in it, and it also activates the part of your brain that's at work when you're in love, when you're really happy. I'm awfully lucky because I love chocolate and I love working with chocolate and I love working with my family, and yeah, I wouldn't want to do anything else.